Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on getting started with your online resource lists and with the Liganto software. To begin with, we'll give you an overview of the online resource list software on project. There'll then be a demonstration of the Liganto software. We'll then show you the end product so you have an idea of what a completed online resource list looks like, as well as how an item on an online resource list appears on the Library Catalogue. So, to start with, what is an online resource list? Well, reading lists are traditionally static Word documents. This often meant that they were difficult to keep up to date. Students weren't always able to directly access resources using a reading list. As well as that, the Library and Learning Resources Department may not always have had access to a reading list, so items listed on them may not have been available. Online resource lists, on the other hand, are far more dynamic. You create them using a piece of software called Liganto, after which they are made available on Moodle. They are also far more flexible than reading lists. As you can see, you can include a wide variety of different resources on them, so you're not just limited to textbooks. What are the benefits? The benefits for staff include that you can easily modify your online resource lists to keep them up to date. You can find out if students are using the resources you've suggested. Students can also leave comments about them as well, so it encourages collaboration between students and academics. You can submit digitisation requests via Liganto. So if you put an item on your resource list, you can also ask to have an extract made available. As well as that, once you've sent your list to the library, any items which we don't already own, we will consider for purchasing. Also, previously, when you completed a reading list, it wasn't always guaranteed that the Library and Learning Resources Department would see it. Now with Liganto, every online resource list you create on the platform gets sent to us to check before it's made available to your students. The benefits for students include that they can access resources directly from an online resource list, whether it's an ebook or a YouTube video. This means students make better use of the library's resources, which will hopefully have a positive impact on their work and ensure that the resources we're investing in are being utilised. Now you may be asking yourself, is it easy to use? Well, we believe the short answer to this question is yes. And there are many reasons for this. The first of which is that you can access the Liganto software easily directly from Moodle. There is also a ready-made template set up for you to use. This is to help create a consistent experience for the students and ensures that your online resource lists comply with the reading list policy. Within Liganto, you can search the library's online catalogue for items to add directly onto your list. There is also a Cite It widget, which allows you to import resources from the web, such as web pages or book details, and add them to your list. And then once you've finished putting the list together, all you need to do is send it to the Library and Learning Resources Department, and we'll take it from there. What role does the library play? Well, we'll be doing the same work we've always been doing. It has been more integrated and collaborative with the academic departments. We'll still provide our reading list policy, so please do take the opportunity to familiarise yourself with it. We'll carry out our collection development work, and this is one area in which this project could benefit everybody, as Liganto will allow us to build collections which are useful for both staff and students. We'll also consider purchasing any resources we don't already own, as well as carry out any digitisation requests, ensuring that they are copyright compliant. And then once we've rolled out the Leganto project, we can start to gather data, which will hopefully give us an idea of how students are engaging with the online resource lists. We'll now show you how to access and use Leganto to create an online resource list. So to begin, you'll need to go to Moodle and go to the relevant module you want to create an online resource list for. Now, there may already be an online resource list link inserted in the module. But if there isn't one, you can still add one in quite easily yourself. To do so, all you need to do is turn edits on. Add an activity or resource. Select external tool and click on add. Give the activity name online resource list. And select Leganto reading lists from the pre-configured tool drop-down menu. And then click on save and return to course. And once you finish the process, turn edit off. And then, once the link is, you can click on it to access Leganto. And once you're in Leganto, you can begin creating a new list by clicking on the new list icon here. We recommend using the module code and title as the list title. And then click on create. We also recommend that you use one of the UWTSD online resource list templates, as this helps create a consistent experience for the students. And they're also set up to comply with our reading list policy. Now, as you can see here, I've been given the option to associate the list with a course, as I've gone into my Leganto account directly instead of going through Moodle. You may not need to associate your list with a course if you're using the link on Moodle, but if it does come up, all you need to do is click on associate list, search for the relevant module, and then click on associate and close. Now, the first time you use Leganto, you'll be given the option to add a Cite It widget to your browser, which you can see here. And as we mentioned, it allows you to add a resource from the internet to your online resource list. To add the Cite It widget after you've logged on for the first time, you just need to click on your initials in the top right hand corner, click on Cite It, and then drag and drop it into your bookmark toolbar. Please do bear in mind that the Cite widget doesn't seem to work with the Microsoft Edge web browser, but it should work with all other web browsers. So I can now begin adding items to my list. I can also make a digitization request in Legato as well. This is especially useful if you want to make a journal article or an extract from a book available to your students. So to add an item, you simply click on the Add Items icon here. I can now begin searching the online library catalogue using this sidebar here. And we'll begin by adding Cite Them Right. And once you've found the correct item, click on it, select the section you want to add it to, and then click on Add. One thing to bear in mind is that you do need to tag every item that you add to your online resource list. And as we've added Cite Them Right as essential reading, we'll tag it as essential. And now to put in a digitization request for this title, all I need to do is click on the item, scroll down to Requests, click on Digitization Request, and then specify either chapter number or page range, and then click on Submit. Now, if a resource isn't available on the Library Catalogue, you can create the citation from scratch. You can do so by clicking the Create tab here, and then you can just manually type in the details of the item you want to add. Alternatively, if you found a resource online, you can add it to your list using the Cite It widget, and I'll demonstrate this process now. So in this example, I want to add the book Time Management Ninja to my online resource list. To do that, just click on Cite It. Select the list you want to add it to. We'll add it as further reading, and then add and close. And as you can see, the title has been added into the further reading section of our list. And as we've added it as further reading, we will tag it with the further tag, and then click on Save. So for our item, we'll add an online resource to the list. You can add online resources such as databases, for example, ProQuest. So as you can see, the ProQuest central database is listed there. And we'll add it as further reading. So once you've finished your list and you're happy with it, you can then send it on to the Library and Learning Resources Department for us to check through by clicking on the Library Review icon here. And we'll check for your list, we'll fulfill any digitisation requests that have been put forward, as well as consider purchasing any items we don't already own. And we'll then publish it when it's ready to make it live and available to your students. So before I move on to the next section, a few helpful tips to remember. Please do tag every item that you add. Where possible, prioritize online items. Take the opportunity to familiarize yourself with the reading list policy. And you can also still edit and update live online resource lists. You will, however, need to resend them to the library by clicking the Library Review icon. We'll now talk you through the end product of this process, including how an item on an online resource list will appear on the catalogue, as well as a dedicated area on our website where people can view online resource lists which are already live. Now, most students will access the online resource lists using the link on Moodle. However, we also encourage students to make use of the online library catalogue as well. When doing so, they may stumble upon which is on an online resource list, as indicated by this purple icon here. And if we click on this item, and select the title here, and scroll down to more from the same course, we can see that this book is on the online resource lists for these modules listed here. It also shows us some of the other titles which are also available on these lists. This just makes it easier for students to locate the recommended reading for their modules. There is also a dedicated area for the online resource lists on the library website. To access it, you go to Student Essentials, click on Online Resource Lists, and then Find Reading Lists. And once you're here, you can search for available lists by title, course title or module code, or even by their instructor. You can even browse the available online resource lists by academic department as well. And it's always worth remembering that all of the online resource lists listed here and which are live are also publicly available as well. So it's good to see them as an excellent marketing opportunity for the university and for your departments. So it's always a good idea to make sure they're kept up to date and relevant as well. So this concludes the online resource list and Leganso video tutorial. I hope that you found it useful, and thank you for watching.